students, today let us discuss the second terminal mathematics question paper. Here I'm going to explain the answers, how to write the answers, and the marks distribution of each question. As you know, 6th standard onwards the model of question paper is different. There will be two sections in the question paper. In section A, you have to answer all the questions. But in section B, answer the questions according to the directions given. Let us start. Usually we conduct the monthly examination out of 25 marks. Here in section A, you can score 13 marks by doing all the correct answers. Let's move to the questions of this section. The first question is, write all the terms of the given algebraic expression. 4pq minus p by 3 plus p square q minus 6. What is term of an algebraic expression? It is the various parts of the algebraic expression separated by addition or subtraction sign. It is called terms of the algebraic expression. Here you can see that there are four terms for this algebraic expression, and they are 4pq, comma, minus p by 3, p square q, and minus 6. This question carries 1 mark. There are 4 terms and each of the terms carries 1 by 4 marks. The second question is, write the expression for the following. 9 added to 6x. The product of x and y subtracted from x square y. Difference of 12 and p added to pq. The sum of a and b divided by ab. It carries 2 marks. There are 4 questions. Each question carries 1/2 mark. Let's see how to write the answers. The first one is 9 added to 6x. That we can write it as 9 plus 6x. Second one, the product of xy, x and y subtracted from x square y. So the answer is x square y minus the product of xy, you can write it as xy. X square y minus xy. Third one, difference of 12 and p added to pq. Difference of 12 and p means 12 minus p. This is added to pq. Fourth one, sum of a and b divided by ab. Sum of a and b is a plus b divided by ab. So these are the answers for this question. Next question. Write one example for an algebraic equation. You can write the example as your own. We need only one example. That one example, if it is correct, it carries 1 mark. The examples are, say, x plus y equal to 3. It is an algebraic expression. 3a equal to 6. It is another algebraic equation. 6p plus 3 equal to q. It is another algebraic equation. The next one, express the commutative property of multiplication in terms of m and n. You know what is commutative property? Commutative property means when you multiply any two numbers in any order, this result, the product is not going to change. The same thing we have to write in terms of m and n. So Here we are considering the variables m and n as any two integers, and we can write the commutativity property as m into n is equal to n into m, which means that when you change its order, the answer is not going to change. Next question. Write down the coefficient of p from each of the following. What is coefficient? That also we have learned in that algebra chapter. Any factor of a term of an algebraic expression, it is called the coefficient of the remaining factor of the term. Here, we have to write the coefficient of p in each of the given terms. The first one, it is pq given. What is the coefficient of p in pq? It is q. The second one is 5 by 7 p square. The coefficient of p in 5 by 7 p square is 5 by 7 p. The coefficient of p in minus 3 p, it is minus 3. The last one, the coefficient of p in p by q is 1 by q. There will be 2 marks for this question. Each of them carries half mark. Find the value of 5m plus 2n when m is equal to 2 and n is equal to 3. It carries 2 marks. How to find the value of the given algebraic expression? The values for m and n are given. We need to just substitute the values in that algebraic expression. When m is equal to 2 and n is equal to 3, we can find the values of 5m plus 2n as follows. 5 times 2 plus 2 times 3. We just substitute the value of m and n in the given algebraic expression. 5 times 2 plus 2 times 3. This substitution step carries 1 mark. Then we are trying to multiply and add. 5 times 2 and 2 times 3 is given inside the bracket. So we have to do it first. 5 times 2 is 10 plus 2 times 3 is 6. 10 plus 6, it is 16. So the answer carries 1 mark. Next question is, separate monomials, binomials, trinomials from the following algebraic expression. The algebraic expressions are given there. We can separate monomial, binomial and trinomial as like this. So, what is a monomial actually? Monomial means an algebraic expression. It carries only one term. If there is two terms, we can call it as binomial. If there is three terms, we can call it as trinomial. The monomials are 3pq into 4qp, x by 2 and 3. Binomials are 9xy plus x square y, 4 plus a by 2, 10mn minus m. And the trinomials are x square plus x minus 1, 3x plus 4y minus 1. This question carries 2 marks. If you complete all the answers correctly, you will get 2 marks. Each of the correct answer carries 1 by 4 mark. This is the question from patterns. Look at the following matchstick patterns. Observe the pattern and we have to find the rule. We have learned this well, right? Yes. So, let's see how will be the answer. To answer such question, we have to consider n as the number of pattern. Then we are trying to form a table with number of patterns and number of matchsticks. For forming the table, it carries 1 mark. And if you write the rule correctly, it carries 1 mark. So total 2 marks will be there in this question. That's the end of section A question. Now, let's move to section B. In section B, answer any three of the following. It carries 12 marks. Three questions carries 12 marks and hence one question carries 4 marks. So, let's move to that problems. Question 5, first question. Gauri's score in mathematics is 20 more than 4/5 of her score in science. If she score P marks in science, find her score in mathematics. This question carries 2 marks. Let's see what will be the answer. Here it is given that P marks are there for science. So, we consider P as the mark of science. We can directly write the mark of mathematics. Only the thing is, we need to identify the expression. How can we identify the expression? For that, let's go to the question again. Gauri's score is in mathematics. Gauri's score in mathematics is 20 more than. 20 more than means 20 plus 4/5. 4/5 of what? 4/5 of her score in science. Her score in science is P. 4/5 of her score in science means 4/5 of P. So, what will be the mark of mathematics? It is 20 plus 4/5 of P. If you write the answer correctly, you will get 2 marks. The next one, state true or false. The coefficient of minus P in minus 4/3 PQ is 4/3 Q. Is it correct? Yes, it is true. 9mn minus m divided by n is a trinomial. Is it? No, it is not. It is false. Why it is false? Because m by n, we can't consider this one as two terms. It is only one term. The next, 4p plus 10 less than 2 is an equation. Is it? It is not an equation. Why it is not an equation? Because less than means it is an inequality. So, it is not an equation. If t is a variable, then 5/3 t is also a variable. It is true. Why it is true? Yes, t is a variable means t will change, right? So, when you multiply t with any other number, that number also will vary, right? Yes. For this question, it carries 2 marks. Each of them carries half mark. The next question is very important question. Solve the following linear equations. It carries 3 marks. There are 2 questions. Each of the question carries 1.5 mark. Let's see the answers. 2x plus 3 equal to 5. You can keep the variable term in the left side itself and we have taken 3, the number 3, to the right side. When plus 3 come to the right side, it becomes minus 3. Yes, 5 minus 3 is 2. So, 2x equal to 2. The next one, 2x equal to 2 means 2 into x equal to 2 and x equal to 2 divided by 2 equal to 1. Let's see the distribution of mark here. This is the first transposition and it carries half mark. The next transposition is here and it also carries half mark. And for the last answer, it carries half mark. Next question, 6y equal to 18. There is only one change in this question. 6y equal to 18, 6 into y equal to 18, or y is equal to 18 divided by 6, it is equal to 3. For this transposition, it carries 1 mark, and for answer, it carries only half mark. Let's move to the next question. Collect the like and unlike terms of the given algebraic expression. The given algebraic expression is having 6 terms. It carries 1 mark. To identify one pair of like terms, you will get half mark. To identify one pair of unlike terms, you will get the next half mark. Here, I have given the various possibilities. The like terms, I just choose the like terms. For m square n minus m square n is the like terms. The next set is 3 by 2 mn square and minus 2, 3 mn square. Then one more is there, mn and 4 by 3 mn. Unlike terms, 4 mn square, 3 by 2 mn square and mn. So, you have to write each of the like terms and unlike terms only one pair. You will get 1 mark. The next question is also from patterns, and we have to find the general rule for the given pattern. The pattern is formed with matrix. As we have explained earlier, we have considered n as the number of patterns and we form the table. For formation of table, it carries 1 mark, and to identify the general rule, it carries the next 1 mark. So, this question carries 2 marks. Solve the linear equation 2n minus 20 equal to 4 minus n. Let's try to solve this equation. 2n minus 20 equal to 4 minus n. In the first step, let's take the variables together and the numbers together. Combining the variables 2n, in the right side you can see minus n. That minus n, when moved to the left side, it becomes plus n. Then we wrote 4 there itself. Then minus 20 will come to the opposite side, the right side, as plus 20. For this step, it carries half mark. In the next step, we just add the variables together and the numbers together. 2n plus n is equal to 3n. 4 plus 20 is equal to 24. This step carries half mark. The next step, again the transposition. 3n is equal to 24. From there, we are trying to find n. N is equal to 24 divided by 3. This step carries half mark. 24 divided by 3, it is 8. And the answer carries half mark. So, in this question, you have 2 marks. Let's move to the next question. Find the values of x square minus 2x for x is equal to 1. We have to substitute the value of x in x square minus 2x. It carries 2 marks for this question. 1 mark goes for the substitution. Look at the first step. We just substitute the values for x. It is 1 square minus 2 into 1. And the next step, we just trying to find the answer, like 1 square is 1 minus 2 into 1 is 2. 1 minus 2, it is minus 1. For the answer, it carries 1 mark. So, a total of 2 marks. The next one. Consider the algebraic expression. We have to answer the following. List all the terms. What is the literal coefficient of the term 2 by 3 AB? What is the numerical coefficient of the term minus 2 AB square? It carries 2 marks. To write all the terms, it carries 1 mark. And to identifying the coefficient, to identify the literal coefficient, carries half, and to identify the numerical coefficient, it carries half. This is the explanation of the answers with marking scheme. Thank you, dear students.